Today we're going to compare hardboard versus inflatable for SUP River Life. But before we start, I wanted to say thank you to you, my honey. Today we've been married for 22 years.
Okay, thank you.
But you have forgot that.
Yes, I had. Oh, you are so sweet.
So now we have paddled down to our studio. I think we have the most beautiful studio you can have.
Yeah, and we think we are going to compare these two in three categories: family and fun, touring and training. So the first category is family and fun.
Yeah.
When we paddle with our kids.
Yeah. We only have the hardboard for this season, so we are used to have inflatable boards.
Mm.
But what we learned is that kids are not always that careful when they are going with the boards. They hit the paddle into the boards a lot of times, and they when they are going up from the river or taking the boards into the river, they are also not so careful about what they do.
The durability with the inflatable board feels better also when we're picking litter.
Yeah.
Because if we go into the side of the river, we might hit a stone or a branch under the water, and the inflatable is a better durability to that than the hardboard.
And we have been paddling with inflatable for 6 years now, and we don't have any issue going over a rock or a branch under the water. No damage at all on our inflatables, so they are really durable.
Mm.
And when we swim with the boards, that you don't do so often, but me and the kids have been having a lot of fun swimming and playing in the water.
Going up and down.
Yeah, going up to the board, it's very good with inflatable because they are so soft.
Mm.
And I've been testing with the hardboard, and it's not so good when you have all these hard edges.
Mm. And the second category is training.
Yeah. And I'm out and train every day. You do it once or twice a week.
Mm.
And the inflatable, we have a lot of inflatables, but if we compare just these two that are 14 foot long and 26 inch wide, both the speed are quite the same. For me, the inflatable on the river is lighter, so upstreams it feels better with the inflatable, and downstream I think the hardboard will be faster. And then you have the tracking of these boards, and I think they are quite the same. For stability, the hardboard will win. Maybe like 26 hardboard will be the same 30 inch on inflatable. So it's like 2 or 4 inches difference in stability, I think, between an inflatable and a hardboard. I go for 24 inch wide board when I train inflatable, and I get a lot of balance work.
Mm.
The flex when you train, of course, it's no flex almost at all on the hardboard, and you have little more flex on our starboard airlines, but the starboard airlines that we have, it doesn't matter because it's so little they flex. And then we have yoga. You have done that sometimes.
Yeah, I have, and it feels like it's if I do a yoga pose and I fall on the inflatable, it will feel better.
Yeah, because you want to fall on the board and not
yes.
into the water.
No.
Because you don't want to get
in. If it's cold water.
Yeah, it's always cold water in the river.
And the last category is touring and traveling.
Yeah, we've been touring like trips around 10 kilometers, not more than that. And so we don't have so much luggage on the board, so there it doesn't matter if it's a hardboard or and of course you have touring boards on hardboards and inflatable. And when we travel with the boards, we normally do that with a car. And with an inflatable you can pack it down in a backpack, but with a hardboard you need to have it on the roof on your car. So it's more easy to travel with an inflatable if you want to go with a train. And also storage will be better for the inflatable. We store them
inflated.
Yeah. But so it's no different for us, but if you don't have the storage for a hardboard, it's better to have an inflatable.
So the summary for us is that inflatable boards are better in all categories. And that's what we think. If you think hardboard is better, please comment and subscribe.
Yeah, subscribe.